Journey with Judy. Honest, open, transparent. It's hot.
There's no such thing as perfect people. There's no such thing as a perfect life. So come as you are, broken and scarred. Lift up your heart and be amazed and be changed by a perfect God.
Okay, so I was totally on a roll for like three or four shows in a row without starting, just bawling my eyes out, because I really want to be someone who's just bringing like some really good energy to you every morning. But sometimes I get a little overwhelmed with things, and mostly when I think about the way God lives and moves and has his being and how he just shows up in the most unexpected places, the most unpredictable faces. And it's just like the 2x4 upside the head, and I just got to walk away and say, oh God, I don't know why I wasn't giving you thanks in all situations and circumstances, because that's your will, that I'm doing that, that I'm thinking and I'm thinking about you, and I'm thanking you for not only what you've done, but what you're doing and what I know you're going to do in the future. So I'm about as unreliable to my father, or, you know, my father in heaven, as my kids are to their parents, which would be me. Because when I went to pick up my daughters this week at school, they were like, what is up with this new happiness? Like, this is not normal. Dave, come on. I've been bringing some really good energy everywhere I go recently, and my daughters are just noticing it. Come on.
You can't win as a parent. When you're too happy, you're too happy. When you're down in the dumps, you need to be happy.
That's exactly what they say to me, is they get mad when I'm all fired up, and then otherwise they're like, what's wrong? And so we've talked about this. This is just how I look. I mean, I guess I look crabby, but, you know, I've been around. I can't even go there, Dave. I was just going to talk about the last place I was where there was a lot of crabby people, and I'm so not going to go there. But here's the deal. Like, happiness is, it's at an all-time low. I don't know if you realize that, but we as people are sadder and more anxious than ever as a nation, not just here in Walworth County and everywhere you're listening, but everywhere. But here's the good news, friends, is happiness starts to peak at age 48.
What?
Oh, I'm wrong. I got it wrong. I'm reading my notes wrong. Happiness peaks at 74. Yeah, that's it. 74 is when you actually become the most happy. Yep, it's a statistic that I found. I didn't even read it in the Star. I found it on the internet. But here's the deal. I'm going to be 50, and so I have 24 more years, which I'm not planning on living that long, to be able to get happy. And so obviously when you're 74, menopause is over, Dave. So I have that going for me. At least I'm hoping it. So, but this whole happiness thing is about as unpredictable as our weather here in Wisconsin.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. So here's kind of the equation for the happiness factor. So like on Monday, we're happy. On Tuesday, there's a sad front moving in. Wednesday, we're like passing through an angry storm. By Thursday, we got a little mix of happiness and sadness. And on Friday, I don't know, we're hopeful and expectant or something that the week is going to have a better forecast. I don't know. But anyway, so on a scale of 1 to 10, how happy are you? 1, I'm ready to jump off a bridge. 10, I am really loving my life. So I want you to think about that, okay? Because here's what I did the other day, and it was so fun to me. I wrote everything I was thankful for in the with the letters of the alphabet.
Have I?
I thought it was a really great brainstorm. No, I didn't. Okay, so I didn't only write everything, but I actually wrote a Thanksgiving poem. So 4 days away from an amazing holiday, a chance to eat, share, and bless with folks who have more and some who have less. This feeling we get as we start this day, if asked why we're grateful, what would you say? Grateful for highs and grateful for lows, the things we speak of and the things no one knows. For what God gives and what he's taken away, for our continued blessings that he sends each day, for food and for freedom, for faith and for love, for all good things that come from above. So this day, it seems, should be set apart to ponder and reflect what's in our hearts. So we are thinking and thanking and counting our blessings, even so grateful for all of life lessons. Oh my gosh, that is such a great poem. Dave, I am going to get published with my poetry. You think I'm silly? Do you? Come on, give me some. Was that a good poem? I just pulled that out of places.
It's a wonderful poem. It just reminds me of the Dr. Seuss book I read to my daughter last
night. Okay, well, he was very successful writing
those very weird
things. And so this very weird host is going to leave you with that little poem, because we are just 4 days away from a whole reason why we get to be thankful. Like, there's a holiday that gives us a reason to be thankful. And that's even being thankful about your relatives you have to be with, where you have to go. I know. Okay, so we'll be back after the break, and we're going to be talking about happiness and gratitude, what it looks like, what it feels like, and why, as people of faith, we got to be doing something when we're grateful. Okay, we'll be back after the break. You are Journeying with Judy right here, 6:30 a.m. on Lake 96.1. We'll be back. All right, so how many of us seriously wake up with that mentality like Mandisa of, like, it's a new day, we get to do and be who it is that we want to be today, starting today. We get to be happy, we get to be grateful, and this thing called happiness, right? It is a huge topic. There's like over 4,000 books published on the subject matter. It is, Dave, it's crazy. It is. And so my question is, like, what is your happiness factor? I mean, on that scale of 1 to 10, are you ready to jump off a bridge most days? Are you really loving your life? And if I asked you to raise your hand and said, you know, how happy are you? Let me define happiness before you raise your hand and decide if you want to jump off a bridge or really loving life. Happiness is when what you say, think, and do are in harmony. Hear that, Dave? Not only what you're talking about, but what you're being about and what you're thinking about are all in harmony. Like, who could raise their hand and say that, right? I know, right? Because that's the thing, is so many of us, I am absolutely someone whose circumstances and situations dictate their happiness. That's so not true. The Word of God says we should be giving thanks in all circumstances and all situations because that is the will of God. And I don't. If my kids are sad, I'm sad, right? If my man's sad, I'm sad. And that's really not, that doesn't say much for my happiness factor as the host of your show. But usually I am the person telling you, giving you this great advice. Take my advice because I generally don't use it. But here's the deal. Happiness is different than gratitude. Gratitude is the key to happiness, okay? So let me just define this. When you are grateful or feeling a sense of gratitude, you are showing, expressing thanks. Dave, that's totally different than being happy. Being happy is when what you say, do, and think are in harmony. But when you are grateful, it's not only a feeling, but it is something that you are going to show and express out loud, right? So those are two completely different things. However, they are two sides of the same coin, Dave. I would think that you cannot have one without the other, right? If you're feeling grateful, would you not be happy? And if you're feeling happy, then in to some degree, you would feel grateful, right? Okay, so gratitude is but it's a skill, okay? Gratitude is a skill, one that I never learned until now, probably as an adult. One that clearly my children, they are the most ungrateful people. Little story about my kids and how ungrateful they are. I seriously stand in my kitchen like a short order cook, and they just sit at the island and bark out orders. Now, generally, they all want something different to eat, something different to drink. One wants a baby fork. One wants a plastic spoon. I cannot just like put a meal on the table without them being so rude. And they will not eat if I don't make it for them. This is an enabling thing. We can do talk a show about enabling later. So the other day I went to the gym and the kids had a late start. So I said, I'll be home at 9 to take you to school. So of course I'm Din Delavan and I get a phone call from Kennedy and she said, I just want to know if you're going to be home in time to make us breakfast. Okay, Dave, can I just tell you, I pulled the quote for the day, which both of them get a different quote in their lunch. I made their lunches. I emptied the dishwasher. My man had thrown in a load of laundry. I made my bed. I went to the gym. They were just opening their eyes, and they were wondering if they actually had to make their own food.
And for those who are unaware, how old are your kids?
16 and 14! Okay, so I am on top of their social media and their moral compass, but I guess when it comes to waiting on them. But here's the thing, like, I am grateful to be able to wait on them. Like, my happiness is in serving them. I really do love serving them. I don't like feeling taken advantage of when they complain about what I'm making and whatever. But by and large, it makes me feel really good to be serving my kids. So they remain ungrateful. I'll let you know at some point if they ever change that disposition. But right now, it's a skill that maybe some of us who are listening have mastered, because here's the gig. It requires us to be deliberate and intentional. Like, you got to practice gratitude. You absolutely do. As a matter of fact, I had that thinking and thanking sign up in my house. It was like in the theme of Thanksgiving. I don't know if I told you that, but around Thanksgiving, I'll put this sign up that says thinking and thanking, because I want you to be thinking about what you're thankful for. And so Campbell's like, Mom, I love that sign. Okay, Campbell never says anything positive about anything I'm doing. So I said, oh my gosh, Cam, that makes me so happy. And she goes, it totally blocks the sun. That's the only reason. She didn't even like my sign, but she just liked the function that it was performing at the time. Okay, so here's the deal about gratitude, guys. Gratitude decreases stress.
Oh, yeah.
It also is a virtue that leads someone to action. And here's the fact, is that we are living in a culture that has an epidemic of ingratitude. Okay, I can name people off the top of my head right now that have a sense of entitlement. There's no judgment with that, because I, Judy Hare, also known as the most entitled person. Entitlement is contagious. And unless you keep it in check, it's really not a fun thing to be around, because people who are entitled never exhibit a sense of gratitude. Okay? But if you're feeling grateful and you have a disposition of gratitude, it's really good for you, or your immune system, Dave. It's a bullet. It bulletproofs us in terms of crisis, it says. Okay, I'm looking up a lot of statistics about this. Okay, so grateful people are happier. 95% of people surveyed said grateful people are happier. Gratitude is not an optional add-on at the end of life. Gratitude is something that turns like what we have into enough. See, gratitude isn't like looking at the glass half full or half. Gratitude is when we literally say, I have enough. And what I don't have, I know will be provided for me. I dig that. I do dig that. And us girlfriends are, in every country and culture, more grateful than men. Woo! I totally dig that. And I'm not a man hater. You know I love my boyfriends who listen to this show. But 64% of us express gratitude to feel better. That's good. So it's totally selfish. Isn't that so in theme with me? I only do that in order to make myself feel better. Somehow that seems self-serving. No? Okay. Here's the good news and the bad news about gratitude, okay? So there's a big old gap between gratitude, because here's the deal. Two of our biggest problems in life are we act without thinking. Judy Hare. We think without acting. Judy Hare. So the good news and the bad news about gratitude is this. 90% of you responded that you're grateful for your family. Okay? But 51% of you actually contemplate your good fortune. 87% of you responded that you are grateful for your friends. 48% of you expressed it with a deed. So I don't know how many of you feel grateful, but here's what I can tell you, and I sent this quote to my son the other day. The greatest human emotion is to feel appreciated. So it's not enough, isn't it, Dave? Like, if you feel appreciated, people do more than what's expected of them when they feel appreciated. And come on, we've been talking about engagement, disengagement, massively disengaged, because mostly that comes from people feeling like they're not appreciated, right? So the solution to me is you're thinking and you're thanking. So when we do that, we are 25% happier immediately. And for those of us like Judy Hare, your host, who lived on instant gratification and now just try to keep it in check and realize that it doesn't come that way, we will be immediately 25% happier if we act out of a sense of gratitude. Now, I'm someone, Dave, who's really big on thank you. I want to hear thank you all the time. I mean, really. I mean, I do. Don't you want people to say thank you? Even if they don't mean it, just say it. No, not if they don't mean it.
Okay, so
I'm trying. Dave's being literal here. Yep, you don't want people to thank you if they're really not.
No, there's no meaning behind it. If they're saying it just for the sake of saying it, then it doesn't mean anything.
Okay, so Dave's right. Dave called me out on my stuff. But thank you is a vocabulary. It should be vocab 101 in every single culture, language, whatever. Okay, so there's a difference in what you're saying, how you're saying it, and if you're actually showing it. So that's kind of what Dave, I guess that's where Dave's coming from, right? So my thing in my house is don't only show me, but tell me too. Because my kids don't act grateful, but by and large, I really know that they are grateful. But I can tell you there's so many kids who come in my house, they don't say thank you. But I don't think it's because they're rude. I really just think they actually was. Yep, they really weren't taught. And so my kids will say, my mom will hate you unless you say thank you. So they're like, well, isn't she the one who follows Jesus? Then how can she be so hateful? And it's like, well, that's a dichotomy we'll talk about on another day. So, but there's no gray in the gap when it comes to gratitude and ingratitude. So when you're grateful, you are taking action and returning a favor. You are expressing and responded to that feeling. This is the queen of all virtues. If you had to pray for one thing, Dave, I would say pray for gratitude. Really, pray to be grateful. Pray to be grateful because you then put on a different lens, or you look at life through a different lens, and the things we look at change when we change the way we look at things. And so if we put on the lens of gratitude versus ingratitude, right, which is just failure to acknowledge and refusing to repay. Like, how about that whole concept of paying it forward, right? So either you choose gratitude or by default, you choose ingratitude, which is the same about this leadership thing we've been talking about forever. You are either leading by default, by accident or intentionally, but it's one or the other. You just can't be like in the gray area. So if you forget the language of gratitude, you'll never be on speaking terms with happiness. Don't you love that quote? If you forget the language of gratitude, you'll never be on speaking terms with happiness, because giving is a get to, and I get to go to break. You are journeying with Judy right here on Lake 96.1. Thanks to Cunis Country Auto Group for sponsoring our show. I'm grateful to them. We'll be back.
Sing about, there ain't no limitations to your amazing grace.
All right, so speaking of grace, we got Jamie Grace, and we got her talking about God's grace, which when we are allowing that to operate within us, we're definitely feeling grateful, okay? And so if I did a show of hands and I got everybody to dial in or raise their hand or identify if they're grateful or ungrateful, what I learned in my studies and my research for today's show was 90% of you would say, I'm grateful, okay? But 50% of you would say that you actually contemplated the reality of what it means to be grateful. So I think we just default to saying I'm grateful as opposed to admitting, like I do, that I'm ungrateful, or like my kids. But there are a couple things that we can do, and I'm going to tell you about three, and because of the time frame, I might not be able to get to number three, which is probably good because that's the hardest one, so this will make it a little bit easier for you as you approach this Thanksgiving holiday, which is all about being thankful, right? And it's a get to be with your family, with your friends, celebrating the freedom and the faith and the things that we totally take for granted. So if you have any doubt about what would help you, I'm telling you, keeping a journal, Dave, keeping a journal, writing it down. It is not the knowledge that we lack. It is the lack we acknowledge. It's not knowledge that we lack. It's lack that we acknowledge. Okay, so here's another little survey that I was made aware of in researching for the show. So they took 70,000 people, and they realized that those 70,000 people could not go 24 hours, not one full day. And let's be honest, we're sleeping for some of it. So they could not even go one full day without logging complaints. And what they were encouraged to do was to think and be thankful for three things, for either one, people, two, things, or three, other. And the others could be like freedom, peace, talents, whatever. And they were encouraged to read that out of their journal four times a day. So read four times a day the people, things, and others that you are thankful for. And here's the deal. They were so noticeably different physically and mentally within 48 hours. Is that so crazy? So here's your choice, friends. You can live in the layers of gratitude, or you can live in the litter. I don't know, for those of you who have a cat, and I'm not a cat lover, like, you don't definitely want to be there. So thankfulness is an habit. It's something that we got to practice. We got to think about what we're thinking about, because if we're thinking, then we're definitely going to be thanking, okay? So Gratitude means what we have is just enough. And how about this? This is very simple. Thank someone daily. The deepest desire, I said this, I think, in segment two, the deepest desire in human of the human being is to be appreciated. So it's as easy as rewarding to satisfy that need in somebody else. Like, we don't only want it, but don't we want to just give that, right? So the greatest blessing we have are people in our life who actually can say thank you or make us feel thankful for what it is that we do, what it is that we say, what it is that we bring to a relationship, a workplace, our church, our community, whatever, okay? So it's a win-win when we tell somebody all the reasons why we think they're so awesome, whether in word or deed. It is not enough just to wait until they are in a church or in a casket in the front of the church and we're all of a sudden talking about all these great things about someone that we never told them when they were here. See, we have an extensive vocabulary for complaining and talking about things or talking about people. We don't talk to them. We talk about them. So it's not thankfulness if it's not expressed. So what I do, it affects you. And what you do, it affects me. And we want to be people who are living with a sense of gratitude, a sense of thankfulness, not only this Sunday, but every day, every single day, we get to start new, start fresh, and have an attitude of gratitude. And I am digging that. So we're going to end the show by reminding you of what the will of God is, which is to be thankful, to give thanks in all situations and circumstances, because I promise you, he's going to work it out. So thanks for journeying with Judy this Sunday. I am so not crying, and I am so done. So keep it hot, honest, open, and transparent. Peace out.